Warm wishes to one and all. Myself, my name is Sai Kiran. I am Max faculty in Velamala IT Foundation. Today's our topic is heights and distance. This is one of the important application of trigonometry to finding the heights and distance of various things. Okay, that means we have to find the height of a hill or height of a mountain or height of a tower. Okay, or distance between the two poles or any river bank, two banks of a river, distance between the two banks of a river. Okay, these things we need to measure in generally means somewhat difficult. When you use this concept, we can find it is easy. For this concept, we need to discuss about two things first. What are the two things means? Angle of elevation and angle of depression. What is angle of elevation means? When you observe the horizontal line, when you're taking a horizontal line, that means we are observing anything from our eyesight with a horizontal way, most probably in horizontal way. When you observe the anything from the above the horizontal way, and here the angle will be formed, this angle we can call it as angle of elevation. Nothing but how we can remember this one. Okay, we can treat as a, this is horizontal line. Okay, this is we can call it as line of observation. We can need as line of observation. Whenever the line of observation is above the horizontal line, then angle will be formed. That angle we can call it as angle of elevation. In the same way, whenever we are taking the horizontal line, here it is a horizontal line, and the line of observation is down. Okay, here this is horizontal line. This is line of observation. Okay, here some angle will be formed. This angle we can call it as angle of depression. Okay, how you can remember the angle of elevation and the angle of depression? When we are seeing any building on a road, when we want to see the elevation of that building. What is elevation of that building means? When you want to see any design of the building, that is called elevation. When we are observing that building, when we are seeing the eyesight is above the horizontal way and above the horizontal line. In the same way, here once observe, when we are observing the straight forward, it is horizontal line way. Okay, when we are seeing the above the horizontal way, then it is called elevation. That means when we are observing the elevation of that building, elevation means design of that building, we are seeing up, that means that is angle of elevation. When we are seeing the downwards, when you want to see your foot, then we are seeing the down, then that is we are looking down. Okay, then that is angle of depression. We want to understand this concept briefly means we can go with example, then we can understand it is easily. Okay, next we can go with examples. They are given an example. A kite is flying at a height of 75 meters above the ground, and the string attached to the kite is temporarily tied at a point on the ground. The inclination of a string with the ground is 60 degrees. Then we have to find the length of the string. Okay, just here once of the a kite is flying at the height of they are given a height of a kite. Okay, here it is the kite is there. Okay, height of the kite is there. Okay, here they are given, this is 75 meters. Okay, the string of the, sorry, and one more thing, what is there given? String is attached to the kite, is temporary tied with a point on the ground. Okay, ground, some point it is there. The string is attached to the ground at some point. Okay, then it will form a some right angle triangle. Okay, here the angle between the inclination of a string with the ground, that is nothing but angle between a string and ground, it is given to be 60 degrees. It is given to be 60 degrees. Observe, we can give the names. Here it is ABC triangle. We are getting ABC triangle. Then we have to find the length of the string. Length of the string means that is nothing but here BC is the nothing but length of the string. Okay, and one more thing they are given, no slack in the string, that is no bending in the string. Okay, nothing but there is no bend of the string. Okay, just here we have to find the length of the string. Okay, from triangle ABC. Okay, from triangle ABC. Okay, they are given, this is right angle triangle means we know then it is hypotenuse. We know this is hypotenuse. Okay, whenever this is the angle, then we can say this is opposite side, this is adjacent side, and this is hypotenuse. We know. Okay, we want to find sine 60. That means sine 60, angle at 60. Then we know the ratio. What is sine ratio? Means opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite by hypotenuse. What is opposite? Means AC by hypotenuse is BC. Okay. What is AC? Means 75 meters by BC. Okay, just here once of the sine 60 value, already we know sine 60 value is root 3 by 2, which is equal to how much we are getting? 75 by BC. Just here we can do cross multiplication. Root 3 into BC is equal to 75 into 2. Okay, root 3 into BC is equal to 150. Okay, we want to find a BC value. That means BC is equal to 150 by root 3. Whenever the denominator is irrational number, we need to rationalize. Whenever we can rationalize this one, we need to multiply with root 3 into root 3. Then we have to find BC. What is BC? Means 150 into root 3 by root 3 into root 3 means 3. 3 table here it is 50 10. That means BC is equal to 50 root 3. Here the units they are given, meters. Okay, what is BC? Means okay, length of the string only, na? That means therefore the length of the string is 50 root 3 meters. Okay, we can observe the next example. If the angle of elevation of the top of the tower of a height 100 meter from a point to the its foot is okay tan inverse 4/5, then the distance from the point to its foot is, they are given the angle of elevation of the top of the tower. Okay, one of the tower they are given, here it is the tower. Okay, with this, this is base. Okay, nothing but a foot. Okay, land, whatever it is. Okay, what is they are given? The angle of elevation of the top of the tower from 100 meters. Okay, sorry, height 100 meters from a point to a foot. Okay, this is 100 meters height tower they are given. Okay, the angle of elevation from the point on a foot. Okay, some point on a foot they are given. The angle of elevation, here the angle of elevation how much they are given? Means tan inverse, okay, 4/5. Tan inverse 4/5. Then we want to find the distance from a point to foot of the tower. Foot of the nothing but foot means foot of the tower. Okay, they are given. Okay, one of the triangle, nothing but it is looking like, okay, one of the right angle triangle. Okay, they are given height of the tower. Here BC is the height of the tower. We want to find the distance from a point to foot of the tower, that is AB point, AB distance. Okay, they are given, okay, angle of elevation is tan inverse of 4/5. Okay, for example, the angle of elevation we are treated as theta. This is some angle theta. Then we are treated as some angle theta. Let theta is equal to tan inverse 4/5. Okay, then tan inverse will send to this side, means it will become tan theta is equal to 4/5. Okay, angle of elevation we are treated as tan inverse 4/5, we are treated as it is theta. Then tan theta is equal to what we are getting? 4/5. Tan theta is equal to 4/5 means what? Tan ratio, what we can write? Opposite by adjacent. Whenever this is the angle, this will become opposite, this will become adjacent. Okay, they are given the opposite by adjacent ratio we are getting. What we are getting? 4 is to 5. Then what is opposite and what is adjacent? Means it is multiple of 4 and multiple of 5. That means opposite side is become multiple of 4. That means I am taking as it is 4x, and adjacent side is multiple of 5. That means 5x. Okay, they are given opposite side. What is opposite side means? 100. That means 4x is equal to 100. Then x is equal to what we are getting means 100 by 4. We are simplifying this one means what we are getting? 25. X value we are getting 25. Okay, just substitute x value in adjacent. Then adjacent is equal to what we are getting? 5 into 25. That is nothing but 525 is 125. Okay, they are given units is meter. What is adjacent means? AB only. Na? That means AB is equal to 125. They are asking distance from a point to foot of the tower. Distance from a point to foot of the tower means AB. What is AB means? 125 meter. Okay, we can observe next example. A pole being broken by a wind, the top struck at the ground at an angle of 30 degrees and at a distance of 21 meters from the foot of the pole. Then we have to find the pole height of the pole. That is nothing but, okay, here it is a one of the pole. It is broken by a wind. Okay, here some place it is broken. Okay, that broken part will be touches the ground. It touches the ground. Okay, they are given touches the ground at an angle of 30 degrees. That means here the angle between them is 30 degrees. And one more thing is, what is they are given? And at a distance of 21 meter from the foot of the pole. That means here to here it is 21 meters they are given. Okay, then we have to find the whole height of a pole. Whole height of a pole, that is nothing but here they are given A, B, C. Okay, you can take this is some point D. Okay, we want to find the whole height of a pole means nothing but AC and CD. Okay, that is nothing but AD length is nothing but whole height of a pole. The CD, whenever it is broken and it touches the ground, means CD is nothing but BC length. CD is nothing but BC. That means we have to find the whole height of a pole means nothing but AC length and BC length. We can add means we can get whole height of a pole. That means how we can find that one. Just here we are getting it is nothing but looking like a right angle triangle. When we are taking the triangle ABC. Okay, they are given one of the angle 30 degrees. Then related to 30 degrees, we want to find this is opposite, this is hypotenuse. Okay, what is they are given means? Okay, adjacent they are given. Related to adjacent and hypotenuse. Related to adjacent and hypotenuse. What is the trigonometric ratio? It is there. Related to adjacent and hypotenuse, cos theta is there. That means we have to take the cos 30 degrees. Cos 30 degrees. What is cos 30 means? Adjacent. Adjacent by hypotenuse. Okay, what is adjacent here means? AB by BC. What is AB means? 21 by BC. Okay, here cos 30 means what we know? Cos 30 value is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 is equal to 21 by BC. When you do cross multiplication, then what you are getting? Root 3 BC is equal to 21 into 2. That is 42. Okay, we want BC. What is BC means? 42 by root 3. Okay, the denominator is irrational number. Then we have to rationalize root 3 into root 3. Again, we have to multiply and divide. Then BC is equal to what you are getting means 42 into root 3 by 3. 3 table here it is 14 times. Then BC is equal to what you are getting? 14 root 3. Okay, they are given meters. Then we can get units is meter. BC what we are getting? 14 root 3. Okay, in the same way we are getting whenever it is 14 root 3, we want to find, okay, opposite side. Opposite side means we can apply same from the same triangle, sine 30. What is sine 30 means? Opposite by hypotenuse. What is opposite means? AC by BC. Okay, sine 30 value is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 AC value we don't know. BC value how much we are getting? 14 root 3. We want AC. Okay, just 14 root 3 is in division. It will send to this side means multiplication. That is nothing but 14 root 3 by 2. 14 root 3 by 2 means 7, that is AC is equal to 7 root 3. Okay, 7 root 3 meter. Okay, we got it AC and BC. We want to find the whole height of a pole. Whole height of a pole means AC plus CD. CD is nothing but BC. Why? Because that is a broken part, it touches the ground, means nothing but it is equal to the BC. That means what we can get? Height. Height of pole is equal to what we can take? AC plus BC. AC is 7 root 3 plus BC is 14 root 3. That means it is nothing but 21 root 3 meters. Okay. That is the height of a pole, height of a pole. Okay. You can observe the next example. The electric pole sustained an angle of 30 degrees at a point on the same level as its foot. At a second point B meters above the first, the depression of the foot of the tower is 60 degrees. Then we have to find the height of the tower. Here, tower is nothing but electric pole. Okay, electric pole sustained an angle of 30 degrees at a point on the same level as its foot. Okay, this is electric pole. Okay, it sustained 30 degrees angle. It sustained 30 degrees angle at a point on the foot. Foot of the some level, same level of the foot. Okay, and at a second point B meters above the first. Okay, here it is the first point. Okay, we have to take a second point B meters above the first. This is B meters. B meters above the first. Okay, and after what is there given? The depression of the foot of the tower is 60 degrees. Okay, we have to observe the horizontal line. Okay, from that horizontal line, okay, depression of the foot of the tower. Depression of the foot of the tower, it is 60 degrees, they are given. Okay, once observe, this is horizontal line. Whenever they are given horizontal line, it is parallel to the base. Base is nothing but here, foot of the foot is nothing but earth, whatever it is, down face. Okay, it is both or then whenever these two are parallel. Okay, when we can treat as it is a transversal. Whenever it is a transversal, alternate interior angles are equal in transversal. When the two lines are parallel, that means here it is also 60 degrees. Okay, once again, this full angle make a right angle and this full angle make a right angle. Okay, they want to find the height of the tower. Height of the tower in terms of P we want to find. Okay, observe. Okay, we can give the names of the triangle A, B, C, here it is T. Okay, observe. Now we want to find the height of the tower, means nothing but here BC we want to find. Okay, observe the triangle ABD. Observe the triangle ABD. Observe the triangle ABD. Okay, they are given one of the angle is 60 degrees. Here the angle is 60 degrees, then it is, it will become opposite, it will become adjacent. Then related to those two sides. Why we are taking those two sides only means this side is related to another triangle also. That's why we want to take this side. And what are the things they are given? Opposite side is given. That's why we have to take tan theta, tan 60 degrees. Tan 60 degrees is equal to what we can write? Opposite. Opposite is B by adjacent is AB. Directly can I write B by AB. Tan 60 value is root 3. Tan 60 value is root 3 is equal to B by AB. We want to find AB. AB is equal to what we can get? B by root 3. Okay, we are getting AB value is B by root 3. The same way we have to take a triangle ABC. When we are taking ABC triangle, again one of the angles they are given 30 degrees. Okay, we have to take the height, we want to find the height of a tower. Height of a tower is nothing but BC and we know AB. Related to these two sides, we have to take again tan 30. Tan 30 degrees is equal to what we can write? BC by AB. Okay, tan 30 means 1 by root 3 is equal to BC, means how much? Okay, we don't know the BC, we want to find BC only. AB means how much? B by root 3. Okay, B by root 3 is in denominator, that is in division, it will send to this side, means multiplication. That means what we are getting? 1 by root 3 into b by root 3, which is equal to bc. Okay, when you multiply root 3, root 3, then we are getting bc is equal to 1 by b by 3 meters. They are given meters units. Okay, bc is equal to b by 3 meters means, what is bc means? Height of the tower.